Prince of Persia Sands of Time remake is disappointing, Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is a step down from Modern Warfare, and some details regarding the gameplay of Immortals Fenyx Rising. Hello everybody and welcome to a new episode of Top Gaming News. My name is Gin Manus, and before we jump into it, make sure to hit that like button and comment down below as the video goes on. Gods and Monsters, which is now renamed to Immortals Fenyx Rising, got a first glimpse at gameplay and what the game actually holds. The game looks very much inspired from Zelda Breath of the Wild, and to be honest, it kind of looks like one at the same time. It will be an open world game with a number of quests, RPG style skill tree and equipment upgrades. You can just go around and wander this open world because there are lots of side quests, there are a lot of puzzles needed to be solved, and there are lots of those things. So it's gonna be fun just going through all of these. Some of these puzzles can be multi-step, meaning that if you have to solve this very puzzle, you have to go to some other puzzles and then complete them, then come back to this very puzzle, and then you are able to solve this one. Now don't worry, all of these solving does actually have some reward. You can go back and upgrade your equipment, you can earn some skill that will help you, you know, going up in the skill tree. Combat here is kind of different than that of Zelda. There's a lot of combination that is here in this game. You can sword swipe, you can dodge, you can roll, you can parry attacks, you can also have some skills that you can use in the game. There are some special moves that you can use, such as summoning this big hammer of yours and then using it. You can even use a forward dash that always helps in the fights, and so much more, I guess. We saw this mini boss battle as well in the game, which was pretty fun, but it was not that hard to do because you have these skills and you have a different type of combination of attacks. So I think it was quite easy when I saw the trailer, but I don't know, maybe it could become difficult. But the most important thing is the open world that this game has, and solving different type of puzzles to gain these upgrades, the skill points that can help you in later down in the line for the story, and maybe build you up even much more better. I think you can have a much better armor set on yourself that looks pretty cool. And the game is also cartoonish, which actually is very pleasing to the eyes. I think a lot of people also want like detailed, realistic kind of feel to the game, which is good at some point, but in some games it's not really necessary, and this cartoonish feeling I think is very, very cool in my opinion. Immortals Fenyx Rising will be coming on December 3rd this very year, and I hope that the game does good because they even changed the name from Gods and Monsters to Immortal Fenyx Rising. And I hope that this game brings something better because we also have narration done by Zeus and Prometheus. That's pretty cool. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think about Immortals Fenyx Rising? Are you gonna try that game? Let me know in the comments. One of the best things we got to see in Ubisoft Forward was the remake of Prince of Persia Sands of Time. The original game came back in 2003, and it's one of the games that I originally owned, but because at that time we had like discs, physical copies, and not digital copies, so I lost it. Yep, it's gone. I cannot find it. The remake is actually being done by Ubisoft Pune, which is absolutely amazing. I think this is the first time a game will be completely made in India from Ubisoft. I'm really looking forward to it because, to be honest, the game doesn't look bad. It looks actually really, really cool. And to be honest, I think a lot of people in India will play it anyway because it's a game that everybody loves. It's also a game from where Assassin's Creed was born. Although now Assassin's Creed has taken a different turn altogether, they're redoing a lot of things, such as including motion capture and animations and combats. Yuri Lowenthal is reprising the role of Prince, whereas Supinder Reich is playing the role of Farah, which I have to say, she looks absolutely cool. Thing is that in the original game, the original voice actors didn't even meet in the recording booth, so they have to just like imagine and then voice act. But this time, since they're doing motion captures, for the first time, they will be meeting together, and then all the emotions, the real true emotions, will be recorded in the motion capture, and you can see that in the game, which is, in my opinion, fabulous. The biggest change to the game is adding a free camera system, which as far as I know, wasn't there in the original because the game was made way back in 2003. At that time, there was not much of free movements of camera. It was kind of like stuck to one camera angle. So I don't know how it's gonna look, but I hope it does look good. Also, a combat targeting system has also been applied with normal difficulty setting, but there is also gonna be a story mode, which is I think an easier setting of the game, and then a hard mode where you will have to select and choose wisely what kind of attacks you have to do. Now, the sad part is how this trailer got disliked a hell lot more. More than half of the people have disliked the trailer, and the reason why is because the graphics of this game doesn't look that impressive to them. And to be honest, I can understand where they're coming from, where we have games like Resident Evil 2, whose remake looked absolutely different from Resident Evil 2, the original game. But the fact is that Resident Evil 2, the remake, was done in a brand new engine, a Resident Evil engine, whereas this game, Prince of Persia, is being done in Assassin's Creed engine, that is Anvil. And in this game, the original director, the producer, they're not even working in this game. It's all given to India. The whole Indian team in Pune is working on this game. And to be honest, if you see the trailer, it looks so much different than the original game. The visual aspect of the game looks absolutely amazing. I think the motion capture always brings something new to the game, and I think that is what we're going to see in the cutscenes. Now, it looks like the gameplay trailer that was shown was from an alpha version of the game, so the game is probably being improved a lot more in visual aspect of it, in lighting and everything. So I believe that at least you can try this game, give it a try, because the game is coming out on Epic Store on January 21st next year for only $30, because I just saw Epic Store and it was mentioned $30. I think it's a reasonable rate, and I believe that they haven't changed anything for the game, because otherwise the original feeling of the game will be taken away, and I believe that they're not doing that. So give this a try at least. I will definitely play it day one. Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War had their multiplayer reveal, and the game looks really beautiful and different at the same time. So much different that it's very much noticeable that it's kind of a downgrade from Modern Warfare. This game has a new mode called VIP Escort, where you or one of you will be a VIP and you will have a secondary pistol or whatever, and the rest of your teammates will be escorting you to a helicopter. Now, all of that is okay, but since the enemy will be knowing where the escort position is, they will just go there and camp, right? And that is exactly what happened, because people who got the invitation to play Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War multiplayer, they were playing this VIP escort, and a lot of people were camping in the very final position, that is the escort position, and they just camped, and it was very impossible for the VIP to get escorted because the VIP dies. And the moment the VIP dies, the game is over. So I think this mode is not that fitting when it comes to Call of Duty. You could have done maybe something similar, like a search and destroy kind of map, but I think this one, it's a little bit off in my opinion. Black Ops Cold War also added these new cool looking maps like Armada, where there is no ground but only ships. You can use zip lines to go to other ships and use boats to traverse in the sea, as well as swim if you want. Now again, there is a high chance of camping in these games. Not only that, based on the gameplay what we saw, it seems like the majority of the fight happens in the center. So when you spawn in another ship away from the center, which means you will have to zipline to the center ship and possibly get killed by a camper from another ship. The game has added score streaks, which is a thing of Black Ops, but score streaks are points, they are not like based on kills. And even if you die, that doesn't stop. So your score streak is still going on even after you die, which means you can get these like helicopter, the chopper gunner, you can get whatever kind of streaks very quickly and very easily. And in order to compensate all of this, they have added a cooldown to each of the score streaks that you can use. This game also had these wildcards, which are pretty sweet, where you can have 6 perks instead of 3. Another cool thing is that in a normal loadout, shotguns can be a secondary weapon, meaning you don't need to have a perk to allow 2 primary weapons. You can have shotgun as your secondary weapon as well. Also, we have Gunsmith, which now tells you what percentage of damage or changes in a particular attachment will do. Whereas in Modern Warfare, it only showed that damage is going to be increased or decreased. It never showed how much percentage of damage will be increased. And they have also removed Super Sprint, which is in Modern Warfare. That is, if you double tap sprint, you will sprint faster, which is just taken away from Black Ops Cold War, where when you sprint a little bit faster and then eventually slow down. Now, that is good, because that is what was included in the original Call of Duty games. But the thing is, since we had in Modern Warfare the Super Sprint, now taking that away in the next game is kind of weird, because then it slows down the pace of the game. But I think this game is going to be at least better than Modern Warfare. Maybe it could be very much possible, because I think they're working on spawn points to have a much better spawn points doing game modes like such as Hardpoint, which is very, very much needed. And I think they're working overall in this game. So I cannot wait to play this game when the open beta comes out, because apparently the open beta is coming out on October 21st to all platforms. But I think having that open beta will help everybody know whether they're going to buy the game or not. Right now, Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is available on Battle.net at $60 and is releasing on November. Skull and Bones is a game that was shown in 2017, which has been delayed over and over again, where it was supposed to release on 2018 but now is delayed to release in 2021. The creative director has updated that they have been working on the game to make sure that they can modernize this pirate game in the best way possible and ensure an immersive experience and to also develop some memorable moments. And for that, they need more time. The game has evolved over time from the original idea, and I guess they're working on the game to make it even more ambitious than ever. They apparently have this big new vision for the game that they haven't talked about it yet, but apparently next year is when they're going to talk about it and probably release a series of trailer, who knows, but they have been talking about that next year they will be coming back with more Skull and Bones. On some other news, Kena the Bridge of Spirits has been delayed due to work from home, slowing down that developmental process, and is being pushed to release in first quarter of 2021. Fall Guys will finally be adding anti-cheat system in the game in the next couple of weeks, and it's about damn time they did that. And this very Friday, there will be another Cyberpunk Night City Wire showcase that is on September 18th. This time, they will be focusing on the Night City itself and the gangs that operate around it. And they will also show a sneak peek to the original score of the game, which sounds really, really cool. Well, there we go. That is all I needed to talk about in this episode of Top Gaming News. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this episode. Hope you guys liked it. Hit the like button if you haven't already. And you can even hit the dislike if you didn't like this episode. Comment down below what you think of this episode. And I will see you guys in the next one. But don't forget to subscribe to Gamer Connect for more awesome videos that comes out every single week. My name is Gen Manus. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.